Neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now let's head down to the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Blankenship is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. He's to the 20. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And he's tackled at the 33. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. Handoff, and he's met in the backfield.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. They can get some protection. They might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
From their own 30-yard line, third down. He lets it go. They'll bring him down at the 45. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Brought down at the 46-yard line. Run up the middle. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Makes the catch, and look out. He's out of bounds at the 33-yard line. There's another pass to the tight end, and he's got it. Tackle made around the 24-yard line. And this is the 9th play of the current drive. Taken down right around the 24-yard line. Nice run there. And a quick throw. He's taken down at about the 17-yard line. Platt picks him up about 3 yards with a catch. So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Baylor could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Cook from the 3. He's knocked out of bounds around the 28-yard line. Georgia's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got 2, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact that he plays.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play-action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
Quick pass. Tackle at the 42.
You know, talking with the offensive coordinator this week, he told us that he has a lot of confidence in his quarterback to make good decisions. And when he feels like he has an opportunity to put the ball up, he knows the receivers that he can count on to be able to make big plays. That's another example of that. The receiver goes up in the traffic and makes a big play for a first down.
He's tackled around the 48-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. Gets rid of it quickly. That close to being intercepted.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Defense coming and the ball comes out. And they fall on the loose ball. After the sack, it's now 4th and long. The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. He's taken down at the 23-yard line. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. Baylor has a 3-point lead. Out of bounds around the 26-yard line. Field and down he goes at the 35-yard line. Catches it and he's looking for more. And they make the stop at the 41-yard line. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. And he just gets rid of it. So that'll make it 4th down.
On 3rd down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Simmons is back deep to return. Gets out to about the 31. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. The middle for a nice game. Room around the corner. Runs outside for a nice game. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really a nice read.
He's tackled around the 44-yard line. And he's tackled right away. Down after a nice run up the middle. Stop. gets out to about the 28-yard line. From the 28-yard line, it's third down. He's under pressure, and that one's incomplete. Georgia is down three and looking to tie it up. Kicks away, and he got it.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
3-3 tie. Blankenship has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Lovett fields at the goal line. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Well, this has really been stingy by both of these defenses. And the question is, can they keep this pace up, though?
I think that's a big challenge for them to be able to continue to play like this. Right now, the emotion of the game is favoring the two defenses. But I get a feeling it's a matter of time until one of these offenses starts clicking.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. Throws this one away. From their own 25-yard line, third down. Here comes the pressure. Rifles it left. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
Check, check. And more.
Ebner, the ball carrier. He's pushed out of bounds right around the 38-yard line. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. They'll bring him down around the 13-yard line.
On the ball, on the ball, on the ball.
He scrambled. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Big play, and it's first and goal. Tight end touchdown. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 77-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Well, I think the thing, Brad, that I'm seeing is the quarterback's taking advantage of some one-on-one opportunities on the outside for some big plays for this offense.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. Tackle made at the 27-yard line. The Bears really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. Nice run, and he's brought down. Hang on, everybody, because it looks like they came ready to play today. Baylor's lead is a touchdown. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
around the 39-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. Made at the 46. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
It's second and 13. Ball in the 48. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. Here's the eighth play of the series. Slings it. And they hit him in the backfield. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. He's tackled at the 21-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Baylor up 7 points. Run right side. Good outside run there. Tailback, and he tackles him hard at the 30-yard line.
Get on the ball, get on the ball. Get on the ball, here we go. Check.
And he's level at the 31-yard line. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Down at the 37. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 34. They'll go ground. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Sack.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Arnold is back deep to return the punt. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
Nowhere, 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 baby, nowhere. Let's go.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Baylor is up by a touchdown.
He goes out of bounds at the 45-yard line. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Run up the gut. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. The ball inside, and he's taken down around the 41-yard line. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. From the 32-yard line, it's first down. Throwing, I don't think he got anything on that. Another run. Makes it to the 21. Baylor is up a score. Hand off, and he's met immediately. Quick throw, tackle right around the 20. Quick throw. He's tackled around the 11-yard line. This isn't much more than an extra point. Baylor is hoping to make this a two-score game. Kicks up, and it's good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. The Bulldogs know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. They got 4 yards on that one.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up.
Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
The Bears taking their first time out of the half. Arnold back to return it. It's away and it's a booming punt. Arnold takes it to 15. And he just got drilled. The Bears looked almost unstoppable in that first quarter. And Herbie, since then, it's not so much that way.
Yeah, they've been sluggish here in recent series. But I think it's important. They still have the lead. This is where some leadership needs to assert itself. And somebody needs to make a play to flip that switch to get this offense going.
He's out to the 30. And down he goes at the 31.
Baylor's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From their own 31-yard line. First down.
Under heavy pressure. He goes downtown. Can't connect. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. Throws it deep. Almost picked off.
We've played a half. The Bears lead it 13-3. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. The Bears continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Feeds it to the back. And they make the stop right around the 30. To the 40, and he's tackled at about the 43-yard line. They bring him down in the backfield. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. He sails it long. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. Five wide. Tries to fit it in there, but it's picked off. He's at the 30. To the 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. So a great play by the defender to give his team 6 points.
That was a very good play, and that will certainly help build his team's momentum.
He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. The ball is loose. And they fall on the loose ball.
Yep, and turnovers often change the momentum of an entire game.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field.
He gets out to about the 11-yard line. A gain of 8 on the carry. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown.
tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 24. It's going to be interesting now to see if this quarterback can put that last throw behind him.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off the mistakes.
And he's immediately tackled. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He throws right. And he hits him hard at the 35-yard line. Big game there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big game.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Strike to his receiver, no good. Second and 10. Ball on the 35. Been some early movement up front.
Just a minute lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Once and all, going deep. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
You never know what'll happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25. They come out in a five-wide set. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 31-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
The kick is up, it's got the distance, and he just drilled it from long range. Georgia, kick this one off. Excellent kick. Tackle made at the 24-yard line. The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. For a nice game. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Gives it off. They'll get him for a loss. And he was pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what? That was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45.
Simmons will be the return man. Tackle at the 22-yard line.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offensive coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Throwing left. He's hit and taken down.
Great play for the offense, a great call by the offense, but the defense has to change things up. They've got to put more pressure on this quarterback.
He's at the 30. They'll bring him down at the 25.
That's the way you fly to the ball.
Tailback brought down for a loss. The first down catch. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. He gets out to about the 9-yard line. Tackle made at the 3-yard line. This should be an easy field goal. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Love it. Fields it at the 2. And he just got stood up right there. George has done everything right in this football game, at least to this point.
Yeah, at this point is a key. We still have an entire quarter to go, but they have executed perfectly on both sides of the ball. They've got a nice lead here. They're thinking about upset.
They're ready to begin another drive. And he's taken down right around the 46-yard line. Tight end, incomplete. From their own 46-yard line, second down.
Red 2, green.
Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. Strike to the receiver. Brought down at the 42-yard line. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First and 10. On the 27. Tackle around the 24-yard line. And the quarterback picks up about 3 on the draw.
It's a pretty good play here by the junior safety stepping up and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. So at the end of 3, the Bears lead it 27-9. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. And he's level at the 33. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
After the sack, it's now 4th and long. The kick is up. He clanks it off the upright. No good. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's pushed out of bounds around the 44-yard line. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Gets it out to him again. He's tackled at the 40-yard line. Complete, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. They come out on an empty backfield. He launches one for the end zone. Intercepted. It's the junior corner. We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Let's go!
Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. He's got the corner. And down he goes at the 26.
The ball.
Nice run there. Gets to about the 34-yard line. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 46-yard line. Now he's scrambling. And he's tackled right around the 40. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Tackled right away. Fires out to his receiver. yardage. Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Now here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He rifles it. Big catch there as they knock him out of bounds. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Knocked out of bounds at the 48-yard line. Five wide. Going deep. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds. They'll bring him down at the 5-yard line. They come out in a goal line set. Touchdown, Georgia! They'll go for two in this situation. So with just over 3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is 27-17, Baylor. He's tackled at the 43. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. From the 40-yard line, second down. Just under three to go in regulation.
Black five, black five. Get a little back.
Makes it out to about the 26.
It's a good job of converting on third down with the running game.
From the 26-yard line, first down. They try him again, and this time they've got him in the backfield.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Georgia's out of timeouts. And he carries the ball for a nice game. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks away. And it is good. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 22. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 39. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Slings it. And he's taken down at the 11-yard line. Under a minute left. And he stops the clock with a spike. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 11. Throws this one away. He throws it. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. The extra point. Tackle made at the 43-yard line. Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. So that's going to do it. The Bears with the victory, 30-24. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.